Amen.
Yes, amen. It's all right.
You don't want to be left out of the room. Thank you. I hope this is for a church. I wouldn't belong to a church where I didn't want to hear the pastor speak. That's stupid. I don't care who you are.
Bless you.
Praise the Lord.
Bless you, Lord.
I found out last night at 7:45 that I didn't have a speaker for this morning. 7:45 last night. But I don't, what I knew I could depend on, I called those in Atlanta, Georgia. My son drives long distance truck. And he had a light heart attack on 95. And she went to be with her son. I called someone to cover the Sunday school. You always have one or two. We call ram in the bushes. Sometimes the ram disappears. Amen. But then I said, I've been preaching 30 years, about 33. And if I say I've been called to preach and can't put something together for a few minutes on a Sunday morning, I need to resign from pastoring and just come and preach. I don't have to have all you have to do when I go into many churches. First time I ever did. I walked in and I walked in with my buddy. He was a doctor in dentistry. I went with him. A nurse came down and saw him walk in. And her pastor, husband told her something. And she came and asked Reverend Dr. Reed, could he preach? The pastor was having a problem getting it. And he looked at me and told her, he's a preacher. She went by here and I saw the pastor stand up with Mac and we never met. I saw him by and she comes. Say, ready to preach? I said, yes, ma'am. I said, show me the pool. That's all I need. I don't care if I'm in Detroit. They look and see me. Dr. Smith will call me up. Do you feel like preaching? I said, I feel like preaching when I left here. I have never ever refused the opportunity to say a few words of the goodness of God. Now, I would want to be called to say we need you for a revival this week. But then, yes, I do. I held that. I would take the 15th chapter of the Gospel of St. Luke, and I could preach 5 nights off of one section. The prodigal son. I could preach that 5 nights. You're about to have a cutoff. But I'm going to have to never to prepare myself. Talk about the goodness of God. Because everybody should have, it's a Christian, should have a favorite scripture. And it's just like a dessert. You can go there and dissect it anytime you want. Not long. I taught Sunday school this morning. First time in over 5 years. But one thing about New Mission Sunday School, you'll just sit there, they'll teach you. Because some good God is falling for this church. But last night when I hung my phone up at 10:30, I said, I have to go for it. And the first portion of the scripture, it came to Mount Trinidad for the 23rd Psalm. There are 115 words in those 6 verses, and you can choose. should be able to put yourself off either one of those situations. Oh, because that's a portion of scripture that's read more than any other portion in the Bible. 23rd Psalm. David penned that. David did some great writing, being led by the Holy Spirit. The first thing he said in verse 1, the Lord is my shepherd. Now, if you don't know him as your shepherd, don't you say that first of all. Don't you dare say it. I shall not. That is, if the Lord is your shepherd, you shall not want. And it goes on in the second verse. It says, he maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He maketh me. That means successful. If the Lord is a shepherd, and it comes meal time, and he got a can of soup in the house, go ahead on me. Set my bowl out, my big spoon, and just set to the table. After a while, you hear. Knock at the door. And if the Lord is your shepherd, you will go and open the door. Somebody is standing there with a boy in bag. Said, I just made this soup. It was so good, I thought about you. You just look up, you don't have to say nothing. But you have to have the faith David is talking about. He says, green pastures, he didn't prepare. He didn't say brown pastures with his grass training. He said, he leadeth me. Besides, the still waters. You know, a sheep has a lot of wool on them. And they'll stand there looking at running water all day long, all night long, and die from thirst. You got a lot of skins. They know if they should lean over to drink out of that river or stretch of water. And he's moving. He might accidentally fall in. And they have so much wool on them. It will pull them down. And they will drown. So what the shepherd has to do is go to the stream of water, dig out a trench where some water can come off and become still water so the sheep can drink. That's the way it is in life. A lot of things we ask for and we don't receive. It's because God knows we can't have it.
Amen.
Amen. God, I know you're praying for a new car. All you have to do to get a new car is have good credit, work 6 months. Go down and sign your name. But if times get rough, you have to give up on those papers. They'll come and take it. But the things that we are allowed, see, we have a lot of things that God didn't have nothing to do with. He didn't come here and tell me to buy no Cadillac or no Honda sample. Mm-hmm. At least I got 2 or 3 of them. But we supposed to have this kind of thing. Normally God will supply all I need. He restores my soul. He doesn't say he did lead us in the path of righteousness. Now listen to this last part. In the path of righteousness, for what? His name's sake. Do you know, church, that we are representatives of Christ? Wherever we go, people should be able to see the Christ within us. I want to always walk in a path of God's approval. That's why in the midnight hour, thundering, roaring, and lightning flashing and rain beating down, I can still go to God. And we find peace. Find comfort. Even in the midst of a storm.
Oh yeah.
And I want you to know this morning. In the last 5 years, I've been through some hurricanes. But all it did was draw me closer and closer and closer to God. That's why we read 115 words. I can read them in the midnight hours and feel the presence of God in my soul. I say, if I don't live to see it, tomorrow morning, it's all right in my soul. Amen. I know, according to Paul, I will wake up in a better place than I laid down. Because the assurance of these 115 words is the path I live and travel by. It says, thou prepared a table before me in the presence of my enemy. Usually in the Old Testament days, they would capture a town or a village. And the man or the king who was in charge, they would tie him to a stake out in the yard. And eat his food that they had took in their raid and eat it before him. His food. That's what it means. He prepared a table before me in the presence of my enemies. It also tells us in the presence of my enemy, thou anointed my head with the oil. My cup runneth over. And this last chapter, where it says, surely goodness and mercy, amen, shall follow me all the days. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. I'm want us in our time of loneliness and weakness and disappointment, keep your Bible turned on the page of the 23rd Psalm. Get down on your knees and quote them to God, word by word. And I promise you, you will have a brighter day. The Lord is your shepherd. The Lord. And he tells us, you can say, I share. I don't care if it comes hell and high water. I can walk in a way I know is pleasing to God. I say, how do you walk? I just say, I'm weakness for feet. For whatever I want to do. Amen.
Amen.
Because this is one passage of scripture. That without a church, I'm not ashamed to tell you I could not have been. It had to be that I walked away in the midnight hours, toasting and turning with pain. But one day, the doctor came in, and he said, let's go to the x-ray. He rolled me out in my bed, taking me down the hall to the x-ray room. I told him, stretch your push and stop. The doctor stopped. What's wrong? I'm not going no farther. What you talking about? I'm not going no further. I'm not taking this in an order. I said, cut them off. What? Cut them off. It's well. I just told them to the room preparation to cut them off. Take him back to the room. But when he chopped the legs off, they shut the pain off.
Amen.
Amen.
And I thank God.
Amen.
I thank God. He had told me your legs would never be no more good. Why do you want to keep holding on to them? Mm-hmm. And he, the doctor, didn't understand. But if it weren't for these little few words, for my spiritual strength, church, all kind of crazy things are running here. Suicide, jumping out windows, all that kind of. I'm not going to go like that. I'm not going like that. So, this morning, I want to thank you. But take these words with you. Let them be your devotion reading for this week. 23rd Division of Psalm. Let it be your resting pillow this week. And keep your hand. Keep your hand in the hand of God. Walk with upright chairs. Because church, you are somebody.
Amen.
And God is for anybody, not
simply.
Amen. You are God's special. He took a lot of pride in creating man. And we are to walk worthy of that proudness.
Amen.
And we should look up every now and then.
Well,
and say, thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Yeah.
Oh, I thank you, Lord.
Yeah.
For preparing away from me.
Yes.
That I could still be one of your servants.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord. You didn't have to do it, but you did.
Yes.
Because of the love that you have for your children.
Amen.
Good morning, God. We want to thank you for these few moments that we have been allowed to talk of your goodness, your mercy, and your endurance. Walk with us this week, Lord, as we go to and fro.
Lord Jesus.
What place is our retirement center?
Yes, Lord Jesus.
We want to go nowhere that we can take you with us.
Yes.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Go to the church, Lord. If there's anyone here that don't have Jesus, I ain't going to say they don't know him. Don't have him as your personal Savior. Give yourself to him right now. God's promise to no one. Father God, but we don't have one that you don't know what it is already.
Uh-huh.
So I ask your Father God to go through one to one. And go to all of us together. And give us our perfect ways. Help us, O Lord, to walk in a way that's pleasing to you. Let us live each and every day of our life. As if we are those was our last day. Which it could be, O Lord. We don't know when, where, and how. But someday. Oh, Almighty God, someday. We're going to leave this old planet. And oh, Father God, let us be live such a life. And we know our presence will be with you. Father God, where the word of God says that no more sickness. Oh, no more crying. Just days and moments and seconds of joy. Just being in thy kingdom. Knowing that that's where we will spend eternity. In the presence of God. Oh, Father God, I ask you to touch us all one by one. And then touch us all together. I ask you, Almighty God, to put your hand of healing this morning on Minister John Lane. Touch him, oh Father God. Touch him with the healing hand of healing. Oh Lord, he tries so hard, worked so hard to try to represent you. But Father God, let us each one realize that we are down here, are just human beings. And we have our sick days and our bad days and our up days and our down days and our wandering around in circle days. Oh, I'm so thankful that I know that I know that I do know that I serve a God who has the answer. He's not a Whitfield right now, God. He's a God, God. Does things in his own way and time and his own things. Help us, O Lord, but to have that kind of a faith. I put it in the hands of the Lord. And I know it's going to be all right. Just have that kind of faith. In faith. In faith, faith, faith. And through it all. With the Lord. Things can be done. Touch our middle term meeting women all over the globe. Touch that home they represent back here. The job they represented back here. And let us, O Lord, live every day as though it was our last day. Which it could be, we just don't know. We know when, where, and how death will approach us. But just let us have this old soul. Fixed in a way pleasing to thee that we can say well done. And listen for his voice and touch us and call us on him, the kingdom of heaven. Continue to bless us, Shalom. And we to prepare to make out our calendar for this year. Let us have some events and occasions where we can represent you well. Oh, Father God, I have a young child. Oh, Father God, we got to offer them something. We got to let them know they are somebody. I really don't like it when I hear the terminology used. They are the church of tomorrow. No. No, 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 no. They are the church of today. And we should have them. Working with them, training them. They grew up spiritual men and women. Women and men.
Yes, Jesus.
And they are double blind.
Yes, Lord.
But the training must be can heal.
Yes,
Lord. Not tomorrow. Not next season.
Yes, Lord.
Now. Right now. We need to reach out and grab these young people. Let them know they are somebody in the sight of God.
Thank you.
And they should be somebody.
Thank you.
In our sight.
Yes.
In Jesus' name.
Jesus.
And all the saints of God did say.
Amen.
Amen.
John.
Take what you take about that.
Would you like to say something, sir? Would you like to say hello to him?
No, I was...
Would you like to say something?
No, I was glad to be back home for a change. Remember that I miss you guys, I love you and everything. And thank you for being so patient and understanding and love. If we didn't have love, we wouldn't be here today. Thank you.
Glad you represent us well. I told you why you represent us. Amen. Now, all minds and hearts are clean. Let us stand. O merciful God, we thank you for this service. We hope it means something saved that are helping us to examine ourselves more closely and realize that we need to be Christ-like in everything we do. And we want to thank you for these services that we come together for prayer, scripture, songs, and your word. And all leaving it apart, would they do more determinations? The world is calling for help. We have to listen. We have to be more Christ-like, loving, patient, and kind, and walking away pleasing to you. In Jesus' name. May the grace of God and His holy communion rest on the mind, and for now and forevermore. And all the children of God did say.